In addition to loading 3D USDZ scenes exported from Blender and Unreal, Jetsa can also directly import and adjust 2D images right into the 3D scene. This lets you do a rapid 2.5D matte painting style workflow right in the app, which is fantastic for quick concept iteration. First, we'll need to load some 2D images onto the phone. We'll use the iCloud web file transfer described earlier and navigate to our project's models subdirectory. Remember that the Jetset projects are all under the iCloud Jetset folder, so we can go up, kind of see where we were at. iCloud Drive, Jetset, City Test in this case, and then models. Once we're here, we can drag and drop a few 2D images into the directory. Since we're just loading one background image, it can be a high-resolution 4K image. All right, so those have been uploaded, and now we'll move to Jetset. In Jetset, we'll go to the 2D tab. Here we can add or remove images. We'll set our ghost slider up all the way to the top to see a CG image. We'll hide this image, and I'm going to click Import, and I'm going to navigate to where we had saved our images. We'll go up a bit into the models directory, and there's a subway image. Once the subway's image is loaded in, then we can manipulate it inside Jetset. Currently, you'll see a button on the top that says pinch to scale, and that means that you can either move it around with one finger, or if you use a pinch zoom motion, it'll actually scale the image plane up and down. The image is actually being placed into the 3D scene as a plane in that 3D scene. So we can actually click on the pinch to scale button and it'll toggle to a pinch to move forward button. Then you can still move it around with one finger, or if you use the pinch to zoom, you'll actually move it forward and backward in 3D space. And it'll show you exactly how far away in depth it's being moved from the tracking origin. In this case, we're moving it to about 5 meters back, which is about 15 feet. We're going to move it over a bit, and then there's our subway. Then click OK when you're done to go back to the composite view. And this makes for a really fast, efficient way to match in a 2D image into your existing 3D scene.